welcome to Narrowboat Precious Jet. Today is Wednesday the 4th of August and we are currently at Swan Lane Wharf in Swan Lane, Coventry on the Coventry Canal. So today's jobs, I've got the other board, the other shower board is here. That's from, I brought it from home. We're going to have a look in the boat now, measure up and get the board cut, glue it in place. Hopefully we can get it all done today, get it measured, cut and glued in today, and that'll be today's job. And then I'm going to give myself tomorrow's job. I'm going to go and try and find a mixer tap and a shower from the local plumbers, and I won't fit it, but I can get it measured up and get it all sorted, ready to fit. So right, let's get into the video. And so if you enjoy the video, please give it a like. And also, if you have anything to say about anything I do in the video today, then don't forget to comment down below. All your comments are much appreciated. And as always, if you're not already, then please consider subscribing. I'd much appreciate it. Okay, let's get into the video then. And little Charlie's here today as well, look. He's always here. He's like a little shadow, is Charlie. Right, let's get on with it. We've got the other board off the roof of the car and just measuring up now, look. There's one of the marks there, and I am going to make a template for this one because it's just a straight cut, 74.5 centimeters by 186, and it's fairly it's quite square, so it should make life a lot easier cutting the board. So just carry on measuring up and then we'll get the saw out. Using masking tape is great for marking up, but it's a pain in the ass because the bottom of the saw sticks to it. So when you're trying to saw along, it just kind of grabs and then lets go. So that's why the first piece I took off before I cut, just so that I didn't stick all the way along. It seems to have been all right. Pieces left on still, look. Right, let's take it inside and we'll have a look, see how it fits. We'll give it a test fit up against the wall. Okay, it's gonna have to fit because I've cut it now. Right, stand by. I think I need to take just a very slight skim off the end, a couple of millimetres, and that's it. It's just a very tight fit in there. I've tucked it up into the roof, but it still doesn't quite want to fit in there exact. Right, all we have to do now is wipe the board down. So I'm going to get a bit of white spirit and wipe that back edge down on the backboard there, look. So move you around to a better position. I might have to do it. Just to wipe this down, get rid of any grease and impurities on the board, which we don't need or want. And then we'll give that 5 minutes to dry off and then we'll stick the glue on and start gluing up.
with that. Very happy with the fit of that actually. Okay. Let's give the back of the board a bit of a wipe as well. Fabulous. And then what I'll do is, to make sure it's sealed properly, just lift you up. You're trapped. Okay, so just make sure it's sealed properly along this bottom edge. I'll run a bead, and then along the edge up this side here, I'll run another bead, and that'll be your main beads then that the boards will sit against. And hopefully, when I push the board in, it will squish out any excess. And then I can scoop that away and clean it off with a bit of white spirit. Job done. And then hopefully that'll be waterproofed. And all I need to do then is just the bottom edges and then the joints. I'll seal it a bit more with a little clear silicone sealer, so you won't see it. So if I just put a little very thin run down, you won't see it. And then in the future, I can always scrape it out and put more in if need be. So, right, stand by. Right, that's pushed in now. I didn't put any more weight against it because I'm already bowing the board at the back. I'll put a little brace in there, look, just to stop it. But that bottom one there is pushing the board, bowing it at the bottom. And this one at the top here is bowing it at the top as well. So I've got a fair bit in there. You know, it's a fair old clamping pressure in there. So I'm happy with that. I wish I'd have another board to wedge it at the top here, but the roof is tucked under the roof, so it's kind of wedged up that way anyway, so I'm not too worried about it. And really, it's the seal along the bottom here and that corner as well, the corner wall, that's the more important bit for leakage. And I've put plenty of sealer down at the bottom and the bottom edge and the side edge, so that should be okay. And also I'm going to run a very thin bead of clear silicone on there, and you won't notice that then. And then I'm thinking, going to get a bit of white or opaque perspex for the roof, so it's still white, and then it's easy clean then, isn't it? You know. So, but that's it for that now, lot. So just trying to see what the time is. What's the time now then? The time is now just gone 10. So I've probably got time to do a couple more jobs, although I've not planned any jobs to do apart from that. So I suppose I ought to have a tidy up. So I think what I'm going to do is all the cardboard boxes at the front there, I'm going to go and put them in the car. I've got the washing machine and the fridge in the car. In fact, that's one job I can do. I can bring the fridge in here and have a look, see what it looks like in place. So, right, stand by. One of the other boaters here, PJ, is boards at the back. Are a little bit worse for wear, so we've made him some new boards. So just cut all the shapes out, painted a bit of PVA on the edges just to try and help keep the water out. So
we'll stick these in the place in a minute. There's still a couple of other boards we've got to make yet, but we'll do that in a few days' time. This was just an emergency measure because this one board was broken, and every time he trod on it, it was likely to crack through. So we replaced it for him just to make sure he's safe. So there you go, that's the new boards. So we'll be going home soon anyway. This was just a little ad hoc thing before I went home. And then on another note, my daughter, number one daughter's in there looking around the boat. The two boards we made yesterday. So you've got the far board there, look. And then this board this side. The one this side just needs a bit of a trim, look, because it's catching the box on the step. So I'm just going to cut a little bit out down the side of the board. Just trim a little bit out, that'll be fine. And then we'll have to see if we can get some phenolic ply to replace these two here, look. There you go, happy days. Right, let's go back to the boat and carry on working. Right, I've brought the shower screen from home. So let's have a quick unboxing then and see what we've got inside here. Okay, we've got a glass wall and a door. That's two pieces there. Two semicircular runners, bag of bits, a handle, a weather seal for the door and for the sides, and then two sides. Just wait for the bus to go. So we'll have a quick look inside now and have a good read of the instructions, and then we'll have a go at putting it up. I think I'll do a trial run first without doing it up properly, because if it don't line up, the door won't open or close. So I need to make sure it lines up before I screw it all in place. So let's have a play anyway and see how far we get. Stand by. First glass panelling. Haven't recorded a great deal because all you'll see is my arse. Well, I'm sure there's lots of you don't really want to see my arse bobbing around. So I'll put the little clips in here, look, to hold the glass in place. And the same down the bottom. Now all I've got to do is fit a weather strip down this side of the glass and then put the door in. So, but it's coming together. I think once I've got this done today, I'm going to finish and tidy up. And that'll be me done then, I think, for the day. Right, so stand by and I'll record a bit more in a minute. As I say, there's no point in recording what I'm doing at the time of doing it, because all you'll see is my butt bobbing up and down. So that's not looking too bad, look. And as you come through from here, that's not too restrictive there. Look, you have got room. The toilet's going to be roughly where it is now, look, so you have got room to walk through. There's plenty of, you know, carrying a couple of shopping bags or something, it should be okay, I thought. That's the reason why I wanted a quadrant shower, so I could have it like this. Okay, stand by, let's get the door on, see how it looks with the door on. Right, I'm sorry, I didn't really get to show you a great deal of that. There was a fair bit of cursing, I'll not deny that. But it's in now.
after putting the rollers on the wrong way up and taking the whole shower out and putting it all back together before realizing that it was just a case of the rollers the wrong way up. Nice. And the rollers at the top here are adjustable, so they've adjusted now so that the door is a nice flush fit. So I'm quite impressed actually. And then when you're inside, a little bit of a knob on the handle there, locked so you can get out. The only thing that's not here, that was not in the kit, at the top here, when the door opens, let me show you. You're supposed to screw and put a little, well, same as what's here. See the little capped nut, capped screw. It's supposed to be another one of those to put in here as a buffer to stop the wheels, stop the door rolling all the way open and bashing the side. You know, but it wasn't in the kit. Nice. All I need to do now is then go and get the shower thing for the back wall. So the actual shower itself is going to go on the back, on the engine bay wall, and then I can run the pipes through the other side and have them all nicely polished in the engine bay, and hopefully they'll look quite nice. I did toy with the idea of having the pipes around the back on this wall here, but I want to use that as like a little storage for towels, so that the little sink unit will probably come up to about here, and then that triangle bit here will be just a half a dozen towels in there or something, you know. So yeah, that'll be good. Little makeshift shelf in there at the moment just to measure things up. But yeah, okay, it's looking good. Okay, that's me done for the day. And I should be back tomorrow. So tomorrow's job is just tidying up. I've made a bit of a mess today, so all I'm going to do is I'm going to have a tidy up, and then that's me done. Yeah. So right. So here's what I was telling you about the roller. Look, a little drill. Just drill a little hole in there, look, and then put the screw in, and that stops it bashing open. But I don't seem to have one in the kit. It says there, look, positioning block, but I don't have a spare block. I do have four of these little rubber, little plasticky rubbery things. Don't know what they're for. I'm sure when the door falls off or something, I'll go, oh shit, yeah, that's what they're for. But I can't see anywhere that they're missing or anything like that, and they don't fit on the edges or anything like that, you know. They don't, unless they're supposed to go in the tops there. Look, they might have to go in there, maybe. I don't know. No. Okay. Right. There you go. Right, that's me done for the day. Okay, guys. Right. See you tomorrow. Okay, welcome back to the boat. Today is Friday, the 6th of August. It's a bit wet out today. Just opening the boat up now. Only just arrived. So there's going to be... not a great deal of work taking place, not physical work anyway, mainly because the boat is a tip and I need to tidy up. So today's job is basically just tidying the boat up, putting my tools straight, getting everything tidied up, getting rid of all the cardboard, emptying the bins. Yeah, so that's today's job. So there won't be a great deal of stuff for you to see today apart from me tidying. Little Charlie's here, look. He's bombing around the boat, look. He's here because it's wet, isn't it? It's wet outside, isn't it? Well, yeah, you don't want to see him licking his privates. Right, so as I say, we had the shower in. That's in now and sorted. I've been this morning and bought the shower mixer. That's all in there, ready to go. I need to measure up where I'm actually going to fit it in the shower yet. It's going to be on that back wall, like I've said before. And then that way, if I just come round here, let's open up the engine room. Hey up, old Smokey. Right, so somewhere in the back here is where the mixer tap is gonna, the parts
for the mixer tap are going to come out somewhere at the back here. So I need to measure up in the shower exactly where they're going to come out, and then fit that at the back here. This wall here, I think I'm just going to paint white. I have got a bit of an idea that I might use reclaimed oak boards along the sides there, but I need to tidy stuff up first, like get the wiring sorted and stuff like that. Putting the finishing touches to the engine room is going to be one of the last jobs that I do. So I need to get the plumbing fixed and sorted, so that's all up and running. I might have my son come in here a bit later because the washing machine's in the back of the car, and I need to bring it in down to here to see what sort of fit it is and how much room I've got behind, because behind the washing machine I've got this to fit. So that needs to fit behind the washing machine somewhere, and then work out what I'm going to do with taps and stuff. Oh, that's one thing I meant to ask about, taps. Okay, never mind. I've been to the plumbing merchant this morning and forgot to ask him about a tap for in here, for the sink. Okay, so stand by and we'll see what we get done today, as I say, but it's going to be mostly cleaning, so nothing exciting. Right, apart from tidying my tools up. Yeah. Okay, let's get into it. I didn't film lifting it into the front of the boat, because that was hilarious. Yeah, thanks guys. However, it's in. And that is rather nice. I do like that. I'm not sure how you open it yet. I'm sure there's a way. There you go, just pull the door then, obviously. Got a few bits inside as well, look. A couple of foam bits there. And a water pipe, or water pipe. Gosh. So it's only a slim line, so it's only a very narrow drum, which is what I wanted, because there's only going to be me and Lady PG on the boat. So I'm back inside. So I presume the foam pads are just to put on the side and the top to stop it rattling against cupboards and stuff. How nice is that, eh? Wow. I'm very impressed with that. Very impressed. Okay, still tidying up. Now the washing machine's in, there's even more to tidy up. Right. Right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. That is me done for the week. I am absolutely knackered. For some reason today, I've just got no energy at all. Go home, have a shower, have a absolute to eat and go to bed, I think. So I'm in work tonight. 20 past nine tonight, I think. So as you've seen, the washing machine is in and the fridge is in. So they're in the holes, but they're not plumbed in or switched on or anything yet, so they're just in there for me to goggle at and have a look at. So I went to the plumber's merchant this morning, bought the shower mixer tap, so that's ready to be fitted when I get a chance. This weekend I'm going to sit down and make a list of jobs I need to do. I've just found out there's a bit of a water leak at the front of the boat, so I think there's a seal or something, or a crack in the metal somewhere or something, I don't know, we'll find it. That'll need fixing. So right, hope you've enjoyed the video, and if you have, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. It'd be much appreciated. If you've got any comments, then please feel free to comment below. I read every single one of your comments, and I do enjoy them. To me, that's probably the best part of the video. I enjoy making the videos, but reading your comments is probably the best part for me. And also, as always, if you're not subscribed, please consider doing so. I'd much appreciate it. So okay then guys, hope you've had a nice weekend, because you'll probably get to see this Monday now, so you, patrons will see it probably Saturday, and you guys will get to see it Monday or Tuesday. So all right, have a nice week, and I look forward to seeing you next week. All right, take care guys. All right, see you, bye.